8:38 is your time right now. New this morning, Modesto Christian's Holiday Hoop Classic is about to kick off, and 16 teams are competing in this year's tournament. Many times the winners go on to be big names in basketball, such as the case today. I'm joined by Modesto Christian's head basketball coach, Gary Porter. Thanks again. We're excited talking about all these stories of nostalgia. And you coached Chuck Hayes since he was in fifth grade. We're going to get to that in just a little bit. But first, let's talk about this tournament. What's at stake here? A lot of these kids banking on some huge success.
Yeah, well, we invite 16 teams, 8 from Southern California, 8 from Northern California. And we started this tournament, actually, Chuck's last year in high school.
Oh, wow.
And it's our 12th annual tournament. And it's become known as one of the best tournaments on the West Coast. So
best in the West.
Chris.
You mentioned Chuck Hayes again, and we could be remiss without mentioning all of the drama that's kind of gone on over the past week. First, they say that Chuck is not able to play because of a heart condition. Then they say he's healthy. And so he's excited, of course, now. The Kings are certainly glad to keep him. But when he was a little kid, did you see the promise in him? Did you know that he was going to go pro?
Not at the beginning.
No?
He was just a little kid, a chubby kid with a lot of heart, and he still has a
working
lot of heart.
Working hard.
So, yeah, but around eighth grade, we kind of knew he was something special.
Yeah, and that's when you said, okay, this guy is going places.
He's a little better than most players we have. So,
what do you look for in kids who, you know, I'm sure a lot of these parents want their kids to go on to the pros. Right. Who doesn't? Right. They invest a lot of years and time and gear and uniforms, and it's just a big cost to a family. But you have to be realistic. A lot of these kids won't go on to the pros. So what do you tell them to keep them motivated, but yet keep them realistic?
Well, you want to keep their spirits up, and you don't want to take away any drive that they have. And a lot of the kids, by the time they reach high school level, start to know who's going to be what and mm-hmm. what level they can go to. We try to be real honest with them, and as the evaluation process goes on, try to get them in a level that they're comfortable in playing.
Right, because some people play pro ball, some people coach pro ball, some people coach at the high school or college level. You coach varsity, and so tell us a little bit more about this event. It kicks off, again, through, what, Tuesday? It kicks
Tuesday,
off tomorrow?
Yeah, December 27th through 30th.
All right.
We have 16 teams. We hold it in our gym, mm-hmm. which is not real big, and so we start 10:30 every morning. And we end around 10 every night. So
whoa, that's a long day.
Long day, very a lot of volunteers.
And besides the potential to win, you know, bragging rights, you guys also are going to have a lot of opportunities. Do scouts come to these games? Do collegiate scouts?
A lot of colleges come in. Mm-hmm. Probably 25 or 30 college scouts come in. So.
All right, and is it too late to qualify? Is it too late to register? They already are done with all.
No,
the
we do that the year before, so okay. We have all the teams pretty well lined
this
up.
This is all set, but people can come and watch.
Correct, and we can also follow us on Twitter mm-hmm. at MC Basketball, and it's just a good event all day long if you like basketball, high school basketball.
And cheer on the kids, because I'm sure that they are really driven by those crowds in this, and not only their parents, but people in the stands. It's just an exciting time for them.
In high school, that's a big deal.
It is a huge deal. Thank you so much, Coach, for joining us this morning. It is a big deal. And we've got more information for you on our website, kcra.com/morningnews.